Today's video is sponsored by Envato. This might be the biggest motion graphics pack for DaVinci Resolve that you can find out there. We're talking about 1,200 assets plus that you can use to spice up and polish your own videos without being a professional editor in just a few clicks. So because reviewing every single one of those 1,200 assets would take way too long for this video, I'm gonna split this up into two parts. So first of all, I'm gonna give you my thoughts on why I think this pack might be a great deal for you. And then secondly, in the second part, I'm gonna jump into DaVinci Resolve and I'm gonna show you how to use and customize some of their assets. But first of all, if you're interested in getting this pack or if you're interested in getting more information about that pack, I highly recommend to check out the link in the description and in the comment section down below, which will then redirect you to this exact website where we're looking at right now. So first of all, we can see that the price is $34. As of right now, it is currently on sale. The regular price is $49. But I think both prices are a bargain considering what you're gonna get from this package. We're talking about 1,200 assets and how are those split up or what's included? Well, if we scroll just a little bit down, you can actually get a slight preview of what's included in this package and the file size. It's roughly 3 GB and the resolution is 4K. And this works in DaVinci Resolve 16, 17, 18, and in the free and the studio version. So if that's something you were concerned about, now you know. But if you scroll a little bit more down, you can see that there are free future updates. And if we scroll down to the bottom of this page, we can see the changelog where the author or the creator of this package has already made some great updates. Right now we can see that this package was released in January 2021. The first update came in January 2021, like just a couple days later he added a few titles and fixed some bugs. Then in February 2021 he made a big update where he added LUTs, VHS overlays, glitch overlays and fixed some bugs. Then in April 2021 we can see that he fixed some bugs once again and added more stuff, and then in June he added more stuff and fixed some bugs as well. And then in September last year he added more stuff and fixed some bugs as well. This year in March he added new stuff and fixed some bugs and even added a video tutorial on how to install everything to set everything up properly. So that is always great, and if we scroll just a little bit up, once again, new elements coming soon. So Jurafresh, I don't know how to pronounce him, is constantly keeping his package up to date. And you get all of those updates for free once you've purchased this pack. So let's jump right into DaVinci Resolve to show you how you can use those things to spice up your videos and how simple it is to actually customize them. So right inside of DaVinci Resolve, you can see that I have those two clips on my timeline. And first of all, starting out with the transitions. First of all, gonna go to your effects library in the top left corner, click on that, then go all the way up to where it says video transitions. Click the drop-down menu, select Envato. And those are all the video transitions that you're gonna get. And two of them stick out to me the most. It's called motion switch. So we have four different motion switch transitions. Just left click, drag and drop this in between the cut. Those are super fast to render. So, and now we have a perfect transition. And the good thing about that is you can actually click the transition and make it as long as you want or as short as you want. The transition will act accordingly. So in the other transition that I totally love is the spin and move transition, both of them actually. So again, just click, drag and drop this in between two clips and then just hit play, let it cache real quick. And now you have a very fancy transition. But then let's move over to the titles. If we select the titles in the effects library, open the dropdown, then go to Envato, open the dropdown. There you see all the titles that are included, and those are a ton. So obviously I cannot go over all of them, but for now, let's just go with the bold titles. Those are super great. So actually title 15 is something I look forward to be using, and that's actually super simple. It doesn't need a lot of caching. It's playing back very fine, very smooth. So just gonna delete that. And let's just maybe use this one right here. And as you can see, those are super clean, super good. And how to customize them is just select the title, go to the inspector in the top right corner, and then go to title. And then there you got all the settings that you can use. And if you want to see more about the settings, just select this drop down menu in the top right corner next to inspector, to expand that window and it will get bigger. That's it for the tiles. There are, of course, a ton more. But then if we go even more down to generators, we have the Envato drop-down menu. We have animated backgrounds, animated gradients. Like, just drag and drop this. And you have a super clean, super good-looking background. We can display text over it and make everything look polished. Then we have elements. Then we have different icons. Then we have different particles. And because those are real particles, they take a while to render. So keep that in mind when you're using them. But then we have animated sidebars like this. Just again, drag and drop this. Maybe let's go something here. Sidebar comes in, display some text over it, and you're pretty much done. And then we have split screens. This one right here, just key out the yellow part, key out the blue part, and then just put your footage accordingly. But then there's even more, and this is all stored in my media pool in my PowerBins folder. So in my PowerBins folder, there are three main folders: effects, sound effects, and transitions. So under transitions, under Luma transitions, I got all the Luma transitions that come with this pack. Under sound effects, I got all the sound effects that come with this pack. So we got glitch sound effects, we got risers, UI, whoosh sound effects, and random. And random is basically everything that I didn't know how to categorize. Then of course we got the overlays, 8mm and 35mm. And to display that, this is super simple. Just click, drag and drop this on top of your footage and it actually looks like this. Then select the clip, go over to your inspector in the top right corner, change your composite mode to overlay, and voila, you have a pretty nice overlay. But of course, we can also go to the glitch overlays. Let's maybe use this right here. So what I'm gonna be doing is I'm gonna select the clip, go to inspector in the top right corner, change your composite mode to screen, and right now we have a pretty nice glitch overlay. Then we can get rid of this, and we also have some flares, light leaks, and whatnot. So again, this is just displaying the light leaks and the flares. So what I'm going to be doing is I'm going to set my composite mode in the inspector to screen, and voila, going to have some light flares. So let's get to the more serious part of this video. Would I recommend you to get this pack? Absolutely, no doubt, I highly recommend you. $34 for 1,200 assets that will let you create better content, that will let you create more polished content and more engaging content in less time is actually no brainer. But first, let's thank the sponsor of today's video, which is Envato. Thank you, Envato, for making this all happen. And thank you, Envato, once again, for sending me over this amazing motion graphics pack. But with that being said, guys, I hope you all enjoyed today's video. If so, please consider leaving a like and a comment. That would mean a ton to me. Also, let me know in the comments down below if you like that pack, if you think about getting it yourself. And yeah, that's it. Hope you all have a great day. See you next time. Bye.